CREST, which stands for the Carotid Revascularization Endarterectomy versus Stenting Trial, was a study to evaluate the best way to treat carotid stenosis, or narrowing of the arteries in the neck. Carotid artery stenosis is a potential risk factor for stroke. It's been known for a long time to be a major cause of stroke, and that in certain settings, in certain patients, repair of that stenosis can help to prevent stroke. Carotid stenosis is buildup of cholesterol plaques or atherosclerosis in the arteries of the neck. You can feel the carotid artery pulse in the front of your neck. And when that artery becomes hardened or filled with that atherosclerotic plaque, it can narrow the space through which blood flow travels to the brain. Blood clot can form on it, which may break off of the plaque and travel downstream into the brain, plugging a brain artery and causing a stroke. Or the same thing can happen with a piece of that cholesterol plaque. If that happens, then we now recognize from studies done in the 1980s that doing surgery to open that artery, clean out the plaque, and then close the artery back up will help to reduce the likelihood of having stroke better than simply taking medication alone. What wasn't clear is if other techniques to open the artery, such as stent placement, as in the technique that many cardiologists use for heart attack victims, would also benefit patients. There have been a number of trials trying to indicate whether or not that was good for patients who were at high risk for surgery. But CREST is the first study to look at patients who have a normal risk for surgery and to directly compare those two techniques for opening up the carotid artery. The findings of this study were rather interesting. Both techniques, as it turns out, work quite well. However, there are some patients who may benefit more from one rather than the other. As it turns out, again, patients who are considered at very high risk for surgery, those, for example, who have unstable heart disease, who have chest pain at rest, who have poor cardiac pump function, patients who have had previous surgery in their neck or radiation to their neck, or whose stenosis is so high in the neck that it's difficult to reach surgically, including those patients whose other carotid artery on the other side of the neck is completely occluded, those patients do better with stenting than with surgery. Patients who are at normal risk appear to benefit from both procedures, but interestingly, younger patients did better with the stenting procedure, and older patients did better with the carotid endarterectomy. This seemed somewhat counterintuitive at first when we saw those results. However, when we consider the reasons for that, it became apparent that older patients, whose arteries tend to become twisty and bent and curved more as age goes on, were harder to treat with a stent because it's harder to navigate those bends and twists and curves with a stent. Not any harder, however, to make an incision in the neck and reach the artery for surgery. Whereas younger patients whose arteries are straighter, it's very easy to place in the stent, and in those patients, they did slightly better with the stenting than with surgery. Each case, of course, is an individual case and has to be evaluated by a surgeon or somebody who can do both procedures. And therefore, I don't want to leave the impression that absolutely everyone is indicated for just one procedure. Each case has to be evaluated on its individual merits.